Had a lot of rain so far in this haul out, but things are finally starting to dry out now, or at least the surfaces are dry. So I can go ahead and put the 5200 on, which is an adhesive sealant on the bobstay chain plate. Make sure you slather plenty on both surfaces, and also slather some of it on the belt. And I'll hold it in place with the buggy whip while I go screw the nuts on the inside. And while I got that tube of 5200 open, I'll go ahead and put the adhesive sealant on the lower gudgeon as well, which also adds some additional strength besides the 2/4-20 bolts going through it. One additional modification is previously I had just lined the inside of the gudgeon with some fiberglass roving and epoxy, which worked reasonably well. This time around, however, I'm going to try to put in a proper Delrin or nylon, I can't remember which, bushing on the inside, which hopefully will last longer and reduce friction further. So I just have the trim tab. It's just held in place. And the reason is I drilled an oversized hole for this, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a little Delrin bearing in there. I think it's Delrin, it's some kind of plastic bearing. And so I wanted to leave the trim tab in just to make sure it's lined up correctly so it'll rotate freely. Anyway, that's got to have at least 24 or 48 hours before the 5200 sets up. So that's the following morning. I put the 5200 on yesterday, and it's touch dry. It's still kind of not completely cured, and I just have the bolts hand tight. So I'm going to go tighten them, really crank them down now. So the idea is that you only tighten it part way when you put the sealant on. Let the sealant set up a bit and then crank it down, so then you get a nice rubber gasket there. Well, the boom is done. Reefing combs reinforced. It's all varnished and painted, so ready to go. As is the bowsprit. So it's time to start putting things back together. Almost there. This is the tricky part. Got to get over that forward ledge stanchion and then down onto the bottom of the gammon iron. I'll try using butyl tape here. Since you all have been recommending this stuff. Seems simple enough. sent instructions on how to unroll these battens, because we're going to full battens now on the mainsail. It says just start here. I think you just sequentially cut the cable ties here as you unroll it. And supposedly there's a right way and a wrong way to do this. And if you do it the wrong way, you might end up in the emergency room. Well, there's one. Yep, down to the last rolled up batten. And Craig at Willis Sails warned me about the last one. And it looks like that tape is about to break. I'm just going to stand back here. That tape's going to break in a minute. Point taken. So I took this table out to varnish it, and as I was reassembling it, one of these hinges broke. And of course you can't find the exact replacement, so I'm going to have to drill new holes, and I'm going to have to route that out with hand tools. Looks like it'll work. Well, boat is all painted, launch day is approaching. So it's time to finally put the trim tab on. Well, the dogs are having fun this morning. The idea behind adding this backing plate is so that this can't actually pop out of the lower gudgeon. So this is still a bit stiff. We'll see what a little grease does. Back in the water. So time to bend on the new mainsail. You'll notice that it's white. Nowadays, tan cloth is just about exactly double the price of white, at least for the contender cloth. So I decided to go with white. It's kind of a pain, kind of a pill to get in there correctly, but it's nice and clean when you do. And it does hold the battens in. I remember the old way of doing it is they would just have pockets and the batten would drop down in. And what would happen is if you did any kind of serious sailing is the batten would just chafe its way right through the end of the pocket and you'd lose the batten. What's this gonna look like when we peek up here? Nice. All right, next up is to at the lacing on the foot. So tomorrow's project is I gotta make all these reef ties. Usually I don't put reef ties for every grommet, usually about the first four of them. That means making up about 12 of those. One down, 23 to go. Consider supporting this channel by becoming a patron. As a patron, you will be able to view my videos free of ads. You will also be able to leave comments, ask questions, and message me directly. You can become a patron for as little as $5 a month.